Hi guys, welcome to our channel Home Banao. I'm Pooja from Ale Carton Architecture. I'm also the video producer at Home Banao. And today I'm going to take you through an amazing living room makeover. This is a low budget living room makeover which will definitely help you in giving a change to your living rooms. So let's just get straight into the video. So basically this living room was done for Mr. Teddy and Mrs. Neeja. They had a very black and red kind of a dark combination in their house with the color combination, and they had all the wires popping out around the TV unit. They had the ceiling looking a little odd, and they also have a granite slab here which was done by a contractor who screwed it up. They actually had asked for a French window seating, and the contractor ended up giving them a granite slab. So that's a area which we have to convert into a seating space. And this is the kitchen area where Mr. Teddy wanted a division, a segregation of space between the kitchen and the living room. So that's the kitchen area where we want a partition. Initially they suggested for a partition around this side, but we recommended for a partition around this side to cover the sink area from the living room, and that's what the design is. You will be seeing it as I take you through the design stage and the execution stage. So basically I explained you about all the requirements. I'm just going to point out quickly on what are the elements that we have changed. This is the entire living room. And this is the dark black ceiling that they have and the red wall. So if you notice, when they switch on lights, because of this color combination, the space ends up looking very dingy and dark. So the client had requested that we also make this space a little more lively, a little more, open and spacious and also bright. So he had requested for a blue theme, and that's what we have worked all our designs around. Apart from that, if you see, there's a small TV shelf with some wires hanging out. So the client requested that he doesn't want wires popping out here and there, and that's where we have designed a beautiful TV unit also. Then we have the living room wall extended with an open kitchen. So here is where we have designed a partition. And this is the granite bench against the window. So this we have converted into a very beautiful seating space. So the major constraint here was that we cannot break anything, or else I would have actually removed the entire granite piece and made a new furnished seating itself. How we went about doing this, basically we started with some measurements. Initially, because this was done during the COVID pandemic lockdown stage, so it was hard to get out of homes or have any interaction with the site. This was the design stage that we did during the lockdown, and the execution happened post lockdown. So that's how we saved some time also on the design stage. So during the lockdown, because this was a fairly simple project, the client itself gave us a few dimensions of the space. These may not be accurate to the site, but these were good enough for us to start designing. So we started with these measurements, and based on this we developed a 3D model on SketchUp, and then we made a design. And if you notice, this is the before space and this is the after space. So I'll tell you how I went about achieving this. So this is the render and the design that we came up with. Basically, the client had requested that the partition should have some niches to keep artifacts and plants. So that's the reason we have some play of squares on this partition wall. And he also wanted a blue wall for the living room. So we thought, why not extend that blue wall into the partition itself and make it look like a single element. So that's how we came up with this design. Now, if you notice, we have some solids, we have some voids, we have some opaque glass. So this was a combination so that if we would make a partition that that is very solid in nature, it would block the entire natural light coming from behind the kitchen into the dining area. So that's the reason we have given a few niches which are open, closed, front and back, some opaque and translucent and transparent surfaces also in these niches. So here, if you have to ask me with respect to material composition, we have played with the lacquered glass, steel lacquered glass. We have also played with the yellow glass. Then we've played with some white niches. So these boxes inside the niches itself gives it such a beautiful definition. So we also added four big niches where we have given the lighting highlights. Now here we started off. We started off with a framing around the wall as per our dimensions. So these dimensions, we have worked out a very detailed drawing on AutoCAD and we have given it to the carpenter. Supervision was done at every stage to take care that the execution is being done right. So we first the border was installed, then multiple divisions have been created, then the niches were formed along with the boxes. So if you see, these boxes are projected by about half an inch. This was to give it a better definition. So these are small details that really make your project look better. If you can see, this is the front view and this is the back view. You can see how it's being glued, etc. So the next stage was when we have given a base PU coat of white color to the entire partition. Now, because the MDF has a natural brown color, it's necessary for us to do about 2 to 3 coatings of white over it and then stain it with a different color. So after the white, we have done the blue. And if you notice, there are newspaper blocks on the niches which didn't have the blue color. So that's how we've protected the white space. And here there's no blue coming in. So if you notice in this view itself, the wash basin or the sink in the kitchen is no more visible because of the partition. And this view just takes you through the entire living room from the partition to the TV unit. So the next stage was when we have the white reminiscence and then we have the teal coming in. Teal color that was put to match with the kitchen lacquered glass that we have. Again, you can see a view from the partition to the TV unit. Since we are done with all the white, blues, teals, we are left with one yellow glass and we are also left with putting some decor. So now let's see what's next. So in the next set, we have the entire view of the partition along with the living room graphic. This graphic is designed by the client himself. And the blue wall extends to the partition. Here we have yellow glass and some decor placed and these downlight highlighters. So this is the complete look of the space now. So I'm sure you are able to relate to the before and the after. So this was about the partition. Next, this is the entire hall. If you remember, there was a black ceiling, false ceiling and red walls. Now, in light, it was looking so dingy. If you notice now, with the blue in place, this looks absolutely bright and beautiful. So this is about the partition wall and I hope you like the transformation. Next, I'm going to get into the TV unit. So the TV unit, if you notice, this area is the before, the dingy space and the wires hanging out. And this is the after look of the TV unit. So if you notice, even the granite slab is converted into a nice seating bench. So here our challenge was the granite slab was already at a seating level. So what we have tried to do is we just underneath the cushion, we have tried to keep the granite base and we have worked below the granite for all the heights of TV unit and the seating. Now in this TV unit, if you notice, the design itself, we have given a lot of grooves for some detailing, and we have played with some yellows, blues and teals to continue with the partition element, the same squares repeating. But the client thought he would like some more ornamentation into it. That's when we gave him a jali cutout, a jali design. And this was a merger of two different TV unit designs to give us the final TV unit design. Here we've eliminated the yellows because the client wasn't very okay with yellows on this side. So basically what we did is we first made a framework of the TV panel, the TV backdrop. And we also made the boxing of the TV unit, the shelf where your setup box etc. would be kept. So the first thing for this was installing a pipe so that all your wires get concealed into this pipe and there is nothing visible on the outside. Of course, the main purpose itself was to hide the wires. Here, if you notice, the granite slab is on top and we have used the bottom area for the boxing so that the height doesn't go beyond this. Then we gave a ply backing. So this ply backing wasn't very necessary, but the client had a very heavy channel for his TV, which was a rotating channel. So just so that the channel could be accommodated on this TV unit, we gave it a double support by giving a ply base. Next, we have the grooved panels stuck over it. So these are 0.5 inches grooves, which look really beautiful as a continuation. So here I'm going to tell you about the challenge. Although we made sure that the granite was on top and we worked the height below it so that seating is comfortable, but there was a small challenge. The granite was already placed till the end of the wall. And just beside it, you see there is a door frame. So the challenge here was to cover this. If we wouldn't cover this, a small granite patch would always be visible from the outside and it wouldn't look great. So then what we did is we just gave a very thin layer of ply and covered it, extending it to the door frame, if you see. And this, we made sure that it does not even disturb the door and the door frame. So it's been installed that critically and crucially here. So this is your white coat again on the entire layer. I think even white looks equally beautiful, but we haven't retained it white, we have made it blue. So this is the blue coating over it. And next we have the niches, white and teal niches. We have installed laser cut panels, door panels. So these are downward doors and we have given a rose gold profile to it. This rose gold profile is to match it with the kitchen profile that they already had. So this looks complete, isn't it? No, not yet. We are left with the cushioning of this seating. So the next space is a complete look of the TV unit. I'm sure you guys will love this, and we are yet to install some frames over it, but I couldn't wait for it to make the video. So here we have the CNC cut jali design. So this jali also has been done from scratch, from dot, and it's been done on AutoCAD, and then we've got this cut. And then we have this grey cushion to match the sofa and the dining coverings. So this is the entire TV unit look in night in with a little dim lights. This definitely gives you a more theater kind of an environment. So guys, that's about it. Thank you so much. And this was all about the living room makeover, where we showed you both the partition and the TV unit to complete the entire living room along with the painting colors. In case you have any doubts, please do post them in the comments section and we will definitely answer to them. And I hope you really like the video and this will be helpful for you to get any of your other spaces renovated or transformed. If you've liked the video, please do share it with your friends and family. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and thank you so much for watching, guys.